Here, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy iPod King Carter. I want to welcome you guys to episode 5 of my UFC career mode. This will be my first fight in the UFC, and I've decided to go up against only undefeated fighters. Let's get it. All right, guys, welcome to today's video. So first things first, this dude Jeffrey Lopez is talking so much trash. I cannot wait to fight him. He's talking about he's in the UFC all of a sudden. But moving on, man, UFC has decided to give us that promotion feature, and they let us get to play video games. As a fighter, you can become a content creator, so you could definitely get the bag by making gameplays. But let's talk about the training for a minute, man. I've decided to always go to my peak performance at 100%, so make sure you guys definitely train when you get this game, man. Training, that's what it's really all about. Now, I'm going to go ahead and post to social media real fast, check things out. Now, I earned a trophy called High Voltage. Don't know what the trophy is all about. Maybe I'll go check it out. Maybe I'll show you guys a video with all of my UFC trophies once I get done career mode. Now, as far as the fight hype is pretty low, you already know how the game go, but I get to choose my shorts and we get to finally go into the fight. Now, another thing that UFC added was something called news clips and also interviews from like big top notch reporters in the UFC world. Now, if you guys didn't read this, make sure you pause the video real quick. All right, now that you guys are back, I hope you guys read up on that article. And we're going to go ahead and hop into a reporter on UFC Minute, which is really dope. And then we're going to hop right into my first UFC fight. Are you guys ready? Let's go.
Hey, everyone. I'm Megan O'Leary, and this is your UFC Minute. The UFC returns this weekend with a fresh face who is destined to make headlines.
When UFC president Dana White went looking for a fight, he was hoping that he would end up with a future UFC star. And those are the expectations after he signed a regional champion who has dominated the local heavyweight circuit en route to his octagon debut this weekend.
That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
Hey, real quick, guys, put inside the comment section right now, how much is it going to cost Carter to knock out Costa? Okay, don't even worry about it. You know what? We'll worry about that when the fight starts. But this is my first official fight. If you guys watched my creation video, I did pick that Meek Mill music, bruh. Wins and losses, you know how the game go. But if you didn't catch that first video, that creation video, make sure you guys check the annotation above. The card is right there with the UFC playlist. Now they're checking me. I'm undefeated. 1-3 fights by KO. And yeah, I only got 3 fights in my career. It's not really much to be said about me right now, but I'm here to set records. I'm here to set trends. It's time. It's time to get beastful. All right, so check this out, man. Tale of the tape. This dude has signed up to die. 6'2 with only a 72 reach. He's a dead man. Let's get into the fight. So start things off, guys. I've realized that I really don't have any new moves. And my training went kind of light, even though I'm at, you know, peak performance. Now, he started out with a nice little body kick. That ain't about nothing. But I wanted to spice the video up for you guys. So, I'm going to do something real crazy in this video, man. I hope you guys make sure you timestamp when the situation goes down. I'm not going to talk about it. We just going to talk about this fight. I got him on the cage right now. Now, what I do notice is when I throw my jabs and my crosses and I back the fighter up, I easily get a lot of advantage. If you guys can notice, man, those jabs and crosses, they always back people up. Like, literally, he's at the cage and I'm just walking him down. Now, I am using a little bit of body movement, trying to use a little bit of head movement, trying to get more in tune with the game since I upped the difficulty. Now, I notice that I'm not doing too good in the clinch right now, so I'm going to go ahead and try to break that clinch because right now, I'm just not that type of fighter. If I was a Muay Thai fighter, I would definitely work in the clinch a lot more. But since I'm more of a striker slash boxer, I'm just going to work with my hands. Now, I ain't going to lie. He landed that nice little uppercut right there, and he did it again. And oh, my God, a head kick. Somebody, please hold up. Somebody make the world stop spinning for a moment. Let's go ahead, drink some lemonade, and get back right. Now, I can tell you guys 2 things about me. I hate the new blocking system. but I love the new blocking system. And I'll tell you guys about that in the second round. Yeah, that's right, man. I'm letting you guys know right now, man. This is not a first round knockout. If you guys can see, man, I'm having a pretty hard time, except for that knee in a tie clinch. Look at that, man. But I can't knock him down. And the body kick got me hurting. I got my ribs hurting. Hold up. Now, check this out, guys. I want y'all to get y'all timestamps ready. This is what I want you guys to do. Check me out, bruh. I'm about to do the most outlandish shit, bruh. Yo, listen. I just taunted this dude, and he hit me with the cleanest uppercut in the world, bruh. Yo, listen. I need everybody to timestamp that. Spam that in the chat. I'm just taunting this dude right now, man. I know he not messing with me. I could easily knock this dude out, and I'm just taunting him for the rest of the fight, man. Why not taunt this guy, man? Now, like I was going to tell you guys before, even though I'm fighting very erratic, I'm not blocking, a lot of people are probably in the comment section right now like, this dude is trash, what is he doing? I'm setting all this stuff up, guys. You can't fight a fighter and know everything that this fighter is going to do in the first round. You have to see how this fighter moves. You have to see how he sways. You have to check out how he's going to kick you to the body, how he's going to kick you to the legs, how he's going to kick you to the head, how he throws lead punches, all of that, man. So right now, I'm just letting this dude throw his punches, throw his kicks, and I'm just timing everything. So when the second round come, y'all going to be like, yo, this dude iPod is the greatest man in the world, bro. He the best UFC fighter ever existed. Let's go, man. So the first round is over. My opponent is cut. I don't know if you guys noticed that, but yeah, I was tagging him. You know what I'm saying? Just give me a little dibble dabble, but bruh, look at this uppercut. Boom! Right on the button, bruh. I don't know how that wasn't like an instant health event. I tried to taunt this dude, and he said, nah, not me. I ain't the one. Yo, hit me with that Carmelo to MB real quick. Yo, I ain't the one. I ain't the one, bruh. Yo, man, that was insane, bruh. But let's go ahead and get the second round started. Okay, I see we got a ring girl. Okay, what up, girl? You know what I'm saying? We're going to be chilling with her after the fight, you know, hitting the club because I'm going to still be looking pretty. You know what I'm saying? I'm about to be like the pretty boy Floyd of this real quick. But just to let you guys know, man, a lot of people always talk about the referee. They always say, yo, where's the referee? Why the referee disappearing? Well, if you guys notice, the referee is there for like the first like 10 to 15 seconds of the round starting. And then the referee get up out of there, bro. Like, they only come in when you're on the ground. They only come in to stop the fight. But I wish there were more animations with the ref. Now, if you guys are really watching the video, you notice I caught one of his kicks. I told you guys, it's all about timing. It's all about timing. What? Listen. Y'all think I be playing out here when it come to this UFC, bro. Now, I did catch a good knee right there. I ain't finna lie. I did catch a good knee. But I keep telling you guys, man, it's really all about timing, man. If you guys have great timing, great instincts and stuff like that, you're going to be great at UFC, man. You can take a little bit of damage in the first round, maybe a little bit in the second. But I'm telling you, it's all about timing. If you got timing, you cannot lose. I suck. Oh, did I get too hype? I'm sorry. RIP headphone users. But like I was saying, guys, if you got great timing, you can always get a counter in. You can always knock somebody out. You can always go beastful. You feel me? Did you guys see it, man? I grabbed that man leg and punch him right in his ish. Look at it. Who you think you trying to kick? Boy, if you don't get out of here with that. But, man, UFC, guys, is really fun. I advise anybody who's going to get this game, definitely start in my career before you go online. Definitely get used to how some fighters fight, especially the top-notch fighters in the division you're going to choose to fight in. If you're going to go online, you know you're going to be going up against a lot of, you know, Diaz, a lot of McGregor. So if you're going to fight with fighters like that, man, definitely fight those fighters as computers and see how they throw their punches, how they throw their kicks, and it'll always be in your favor because you'll know how the timing goes, guys. But yeah, I did my thing in the O2 Arena. I got the W, got the knockout. Look, man, I'm all ecstatic. Look at that. I don't even know these dudes, but they're part of my team, though I ain't even choose them. But look at this. Okay. Oh, and we taking selfies. All right. I don't even know you dudes. Get out my octagon, baby. It's time for me to celebrate by myself. Who is these dudes, man? But check it out, guys. Total strikes 137, man. He threw 104 strikes. You guys know, and you can tell that I upped the difficulty right there, man. Because I noticed when I was playing on normal, dog, they wasn't throwing no punches, bro. They was barely throwing any punches. But I'm scared to go up against guys that fight on the ground, man, because I know that I'm beginning taking down crazy. But I got that 25 racks. You know what I'm saying? We getting money. We doing what we gotta do, man. That's really good, man. I finally get to, you know, start saving up and getting into these better gyms. But what I can tell you guys is I'm getting positive feedback on social media. And also, as far as like gyms go, I'm not going to leave the current gym that I'm at until I max that gym out and I learn all the moves from this gym. All right. So I'm going to be saving money, man. Now, Megan O'Leavy, she want to hit me up, you know, give me that little thumbs up from on social media. So, you know, I was all up in them DMs later that night. But, you know, we ain't going to talk about that. You know what I'm saying? I just had to thank her. You know how the game go, man. But I thank you guys for watching this video. And, bye. Alright guys, this is the end of the video. I hope you guys definitely enjoyed this video. Make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, and you can also watch one of my previous videos after hitting that subscribe button. I hope you guys like this video. Let's get this thing to 5,000 likes. And this is your boy IKC signing out. Peace.